Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in this world. My name is Sandie Okoro. I'm Senior Vice President and General Counsel of the World Bank Group. And it's a delight to be here today, albeit not in person, but I hope we can do that soon. The World Bank Group takes pride in its mission to eradicate poverty and create opportunities for shared prosperity. We work closely with our stakeholders and partners to achieve these goals. We engage in the right conversations and together identify robust action plans that bring us one step closer to making a difference, and hopefully a big difference. The United Nations Sustainable Development Goals are one of the frameworks through which we undertake our efforts. These 17 goals are important to end poverty, protect the planet, and ensure that all people enjoy peace and prosperity by 2030. And one goal, which is very close to my heart, looks at the essential role of peace, justice, and strong institutions play in this equation. And I just want to stop and give you a quote by Martin Luther King. It's on the monument not far away from me here in Washington, D.C. And the quote states that true peace is not merely the absence of of tension, but the presence of justice. So peace and justice, and justice and peace go hand in hand. Justice and the rule of law are critical to making transformative change across societies. When there is no justice or access to it, poverty remains rampant and inequalities persist. The rule of law fosters development because it strengthens the voices of individuals and communities. It also provides access to justice, ensures due process, and establishes remedies for the violation of rights. This is where organizations such as the World Justice Project come into play and can guide us forward. One of the World Justice Project's most important contributions in the justice sphere is its yearly index, which looks at the state of the rule of law around the world. The findings of the 2021 index are indeed grim. For the fourth year in a row, countries are showing more decline in overall rule of law performance. There is no emoji for that. It's not a laughing matter. This is really serious. This is particularly troubling when the world is under stress. Take, for instance, the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic and the ensuing humanitarian crisis in areas affected by conflict and violence. At the World Bank, we've estimated that 1.5 billion people, let me just repeat that, 1.5 billion people are facing legal problems they cannot resolve, and an additional 4.5 billion people, again, I will repeat, 4.5 billion people are excluded from protections and opportunities that the law provides. Those are huge and staggering numbers. When the rule of law is fragile and access to justice is limited, reconstructing livelihoods and entire communities becomes a very daunting task. We must recognize that more remains to be done to achieve tangible outcomes, and that it takes a broad and global collaborative approach to effectively promote the rule of law and justice across all societies. We also recognize the need for multidisciplinary approaches in dealing with justice and development, drawing from a network of experts, including economists, social scientists, judges, legal professions, and many, many more. It is for this reason that my team and I have been working over the last year with supporters of justice and the rule of law across countries and have launched the Law Society's Compact and Forum for SDG 16. This started as a nugget of an idea between myself and Penelope Warne, a very prominent UK lawyer. The idea that all the lawyers across the world should get together and champion the rule of law and SDG 16, making this the lawyers' SDG. This new initiative amplifies the voices of lawyers everywhere. It harnesses their collective power in a unique platform to exchange and create new knowledge and capacity building, which facilitate the enhancement of the rule of law and improved access to justice. We look forward to using the findings from the World Justice Project's 2021 Rule of Law Index to shape the work and activities of the Compact and Forum. We also look forward to mobilizing the best resources and research towards designing better solutions in the rule of law and access to justice, and building solid foundations that lead to sustainable development outcomes, something we all want, something we all need, and something we will all benefit from. So with that, I will say goodbye. I'm sorry I couldn't be with you in person, but I hope to see you soon.